This is Chloroform, and today...
To all criminals watching this video, unfortunately, Chloroform doesn't work like what you saw in the movie.
Shut up and yap. Just breathe normal.
Well, will Chloroform make people unconscious? The answer is yes and no. To find out why, we first have to make some chloroform. But before that, a quick disclaimer. Do not try this at home. Any action performed in this video is the dramatization usage of chloroform. Do not try to do it to yourself or other people. Chloroform is also toxic and carcinogenic. Proper PPE and ventilation are required for this experiment. Okay, so let's start making some chloroform. The main ingredients needed for this synthesis are surprisingly simple. You only need acetone and chlorine bleach. So basically you can get them all on a single trip to a hardware store. I already have acetone in stock, so I don't need another can. In addition to the main ingredients, you will also want two supplementary chemicals, a drying agent and a stabilizer, which I've already made in previous videos. You can unlock your tech tree by watching these two videos. For the experiment setup, you can use the original bleach container as the reaction vessel by pouring out about 150 ml of bleach solution, making room for the addition of acetone. However, I want to be completely transparent with you guys. Therefore, I will be using a transparent container. I'm adding 1.8 liter of 10.8% pre-chilled bleach solution to the container. It has to be chilled to 0 degrees Celsius or below. But I'm cutting corners here as I was too impatient. And the final temperature of the bleach solution is just around 5 degrees Celsius. After that, add 50 ml of acetone to the bottle. I guess everything should still be fine, right? Oh shit. As you can see, the heliform reaction is very exothermic. Acetone starts to boil once it is added to the bleach. This is the perfect demonstration of a runaway reaction, and you should definitely chill the bleach to a colder temperature before adding acetone. Anyway, I still cap it and gently shake it to mix it. Place it on a table and loosen the cap to prevent pressure buildup. The sodium hypochlorite will be in excess for this case, as acetone will form a hard-to-separate azeotrope with chloroform if left unreacted. If you take a thermocouple or a thermometer to measure the temperature of the mixture, you will see a rise in temperature. It rises above 57 degrees Celsius in my case. It is very undesirable. So I did a second batch just to show you the same reaction if the bleach is chilled to minus 9.1 degrees Celsius. After addition of acetone, the bottle is capped and shaken gently. There's not much going on and the bottle remains cool to touch. And this is exactly what you want to see in a heliform reaction. Both bottles of mixtures allowed it to react for 24 hours for the reaction to complete. While you guys watch the 24 hours time lapse of the reaction, let me explain a little bit about this heliform reaction. The bleach solution dissociates into hypochlorous acid and sodium hydroxide in an equilibrium. The hydroxide ion abstracts a proton on the alpha carbon on the methyl ketone. In our case, acetone forms a resonance stabilizer enolate ion. The nucleophilic enolate then attaches to the chlorine atom, undergoes an SN2 halogenation, forming alpha chloroketone. The same reaction undergoes two more times until trichloroketone is formed. The carbon-carbon then attacks the hydroxide ion, forming an intermediate. The trichloromethane group, being a good living group, will then be detached from carbon-carbon, forming a trichloromethane anion. It then abstracts a proton from the newly formed acetic acid, forming the desired product, chloroform, an acetate ion. This reaction can be rather complicated, but I don't want to bore you guys. So check out the supplementary links in the description if you would like to learn more. After allowing the mixture to react for 24 hours, You can see the bleach solution cluded up and an organic layer is formed at the bottom of the vessel, which is the chloroform. Chloroform is slightly soluble in water at 8 grams per liter. It might not be so significant normally, but given we have almost 2 liters of solution, I think we better do a sorting out step to increase our yield. To do this, an arbitrary amount of table salt is added to the solution. The bottle is then shaken, not stirred, and allowed to settle for some time. After the layer has reformed, we slowly decant the solution until only a very small amount of aqueous solution and the chloroform layer is left. The remaining solution is transferred to a separatory funnel, giving some time for the solution to settle. Then drain the lower organic layer to an alumina flask for further processing. Add a small amount of anhydrous magnesium sulfate to chloroform. Swirl it gently and allow it to sit for 20 minutes to absorb the water in the chloroform. The final step will be a distillation of chloroform to get rid of most water and other impurities. A simple distillation will be adequate for this purpose. The first fraction of distillate is usually cloudy and will be discarded. Distillate collected at 60 to 62 degrees Celsius should be our desired product, chloroform. Switch the collection flask to an amber bottle or foil wrapped bottle to collect the product. This is necessary as UV light will promote the decomposition of chloroform. You can see that the reflective index of chloroform is higher when compared to most liquids. The final yield is 113.6 grams, which is a 62.4% yield. Additionally, 1 ml of anhydrous ethanol is added to chloroform as a stabilizer. This suppresses the formation of the toxic phosgene gas. The solution produced in the experiment contains halogenated organic compounds, which cannot be directly disposed to the drain. It is recommended to add 50 ml of 6M sodium hydroxide solution to the waste solution and allow it to sit for a few days. This will hydrolyze any remaining chloroform to sodium chloride in the solution, which is then safe to dispose of. So, will chloroform make people unconscious? As I explain my findings, I try to inhale the chloroform vapor as if my mouth is covered in a chloroform-soaked handkerchief. Historically, since the anesthetic property of chloroform has been discovered, it has been used as a general anesthetic for many years in the clinical context. However, in terms of criminal usage, there was no evidence that it was successful according to this paper. The reason why chloroform can make people unconscious but does not make them the everyday carry of criminals is mainly because it takes at least 5 minutes of continuous inhalation of chloroform.